everyone, it's Hannah here from Virtually Fluent. Welcome to today's video, which is a vocabulary boosting video, and this is all about the topic of space. So we're going to have a little chat about some of the concepts of space, and hopefully you can boost your vocabulary in English on this topic. If you would like to practice any of these words, we do have an online language course. I've left the link to that in the description below, and that will focus on the definitions, pronunciation, and use of all those booster words that should pop up on the screen while I'm speaking. So let's start on the biggest scale. Let's start with the word universe, which is the biggest concept that we have. Everything in physical existence and pretty much everything we're going to talk about in today's video. Now, slightly smaller than that, we have space, which is a short form of saying outer space. And this exists just outside the Earth's atmosphere, which is a good few miles up into the sky. Now, out in space, I'm sure you're aware, there is no air out there. We wouldn't be able to breathe. And that's why astronauts often wear their space suits, they have those big helmets, so they're fully protected. And of course, space is completely silent and completely pitch black too. So within our universe, we have many different galaxies, and these are collections of millions and billions of stars. They are held together by gas, by dust, and gravitational force. Here on Earth, we're part of the Milky Way galaxy, which has around 200 billion stars. And our galaxy is often recognized by that spiral shape, which I'm sure you may have seen online. But of course, the Milky Way isn't the only galaxy in existence. There are many others out there too, with different shapes, forms, colors. And when we are down here on Earth and we are looking up at the stars at night, we see very specific patterns of stars, often shapes that people have described. These are constellations. Officially, I believe there are 88 constellations here in the Milky Way galaxy, and we often name these after mythological creatures. Now, of course, some of these constellations and stars aren't always visible to the naked eye. Sometimes we need equipment to help us, like using a telescope, a high-end telescope that we can really see what's out there. Of course, there are a lot of people who work within this industry. These are astronomers. They work in astronomy. Often they're working inside observatories to help them learn a lot more about space, the stars. Now, here within our Milky Way system, we have a solar system. So at the core of our solar system, we have our sun. And moving around, we have different objects which orbit, all centered around. So orbit is to move around. Now, our particular solar system is about 4.5 billion years old, pretty old. So let's take a look at some of the parts of our solar system. So I've already mentioned that right in the center, we have this big, hot, flaming ball of gas, also a star, which is the sun. And around our sun, different planets and moons orbit. We have 8 planets which orbit the sun. In the correct order, we have Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and finally Neptune. Of course, we had little Pluto, which used to be a planet. This is now a dwarf planet, I believe, so no longer part of those 8 planets. Now, most of these planets have their own moons, which orbit around those individual planets. Here on planet Earth, we look up and often see the moon at night. We often encounter eclipses, solar eclipses. So this is particularly when the moon kind of gets in the way, really, between the sun and planet Earth, and that casts a big shadow all over our planet. So that is our solar system and some part of the universe, but there are loads of other cool things out in space too. We have asteroids, which are little rocky objects which also orbit the sun. We have meteoroids, which are also small rocky objects that also orbit the sun. These are slightly smaller, than asteroids. And occasionally these meteoroids enter the Earth's atmosphere. They leave this beautiful strike of light, which is called a meteor, or perhaps more informally, a shooting star, where people typically make wishes. And occasionally it comes all the way down to the surface of our planet. It will hit the ground, and then that is a meteorite. Sometimes it leaves these enormous craters, these big dips in the Earth's surface too. We also have comets, which NASA describes as these sort of big frozen balls of gas and dust and rock. And of course we have the UFOs, the big topic of UFOs, unidentified flying objects, which is by definition something that we cannot explain or define why it is there or what it is. There's always a big question of whether there are extraterrestrials out there, something that doesn't belong to our planet Earth. Now, the people who are responsible for exploring space out there are different space agencies and also some space economies, where huge amounts of money are invested in the exploration of space. Inside our big rockets, we would tend to have some astronauts. Often the big liftoff before a rocket launches up into space, hopefully successfully, is often quite popular to watch on television, for example. We have special mission specialist astronauts. These could be scientists, they could be engineers, and they carry out certain missions when they are up in space, hopefully to improve quality of life back down here on Earth, or simply to discover more about our galaxy, our universe. Down here on the ground, you will have a team of specialists who communicate with the astronauts who are floating around up in space. They will often do a big countdown before the rocket lifts up. They are responsible for that. Generally, a lot of rockets will take a payload up with them, going up into space. This could be something like a satellite, which perhaps benefits us, as I said, down here, or just something to explore further the space that's out there. Now, up in space, of course, we have the International Space Station, which all countries around the world use, and the individual rockets may dock on the International Space Station and stay there for the duration of their trip. Now, of course, once the mission is complete by the astronauts, they need to come crashing back down into Earth. They often use these little detachable capsules. They will crash typically somewhere in the sea, and this is known as a splashdown. But as you can see, the world of space is so interesting. There are so many different parts that we can talk about. Hopefully that sets you off with a little bit of basic vocabulary in this area in English today. If you learned some new vocabulary today, go ahead and give us a like, a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit that notification bell and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can see all of the new videos that we post on English grammar, pronunciation, and vocabulary on a regular basis. That's everything for today. This is Hannah from Virtually Fluent, bringing English to life.